Very good morning, all of you. Welcome to Fluid Mechanics and Hydraulics Machinery class. In last class, I was discussed about pressure. What is pressure? What's the unit of pressure? And how to measure atmospheric pressure with the help of barometer? And the relation between absolute pressure and gauge pressure. Absolute pressure with vacuum pressure with the help of atmospheric pressure, like that different relations we saw in last class. Now in today class I'll discuss about simple problems on pressure using atmospheric pressure, gauge pressure, vacuum pressure, like that. Later we'll move to devices which are used for pressure measuring. Now I'll discuss simple problems. Let us start a problem on pressure. See, all of you read it carefully. Convert the following readings of pressure. Convert the following readings of pressure to kilopascal. We have to convert pressure value into kilopascal, assuming that barometer reads 760 mm of Hg. Barometer reading here 760 mm of Hg. Now objectives were given to be converted in kilopascal. First one, 80 cm of Hg, we have to convert in kilopascal. Second one, 30 cm Hg vacuum. Now this is vacuum. Previous one only 80 cm Hg. Now 30 cm vacuum. Third one, 1.35 H2O gauge, mm of water, meters water gauge. And fourth one is 4.2 bar. These four objectives you have to be converted in kilopascal. Last class I discussed clearly that pressure unit is pascal, which is nothing but Newton per meter square. With the help of barometer, we understood that at sea level, we see the level of liquid in glass tube when we prefer mercury. That height, or the level of height in glass tube is that 760 mm. Using that 760 mm, with the help of hydrostatic law, we calculated atmospheric pressure as 101325 pascal. 101325, that is atmospheric pressure we studied in last class. If you convert in bar, 1.01325 bar. So that procedure will be applied here. We'll see what happens. How can we solve this problem? And one more data is given, assuming that density of mercury is 13.596 × 1000 kg per meter cube. It is nothing but 13,596 kg per meter cube. This data is actually not required for this problem. Density of mercury always 13,600. Directly you can take, because specific gravity of mercury is 13.6. If you multiply with the standard water liquid density 1000, finally you get 13,600. But here he mentioned 13.596 as specific gravity. We follow this value for this problem. So for this problem, density of mercury is 13,596 kg per meter cube from the given data. Solution. So first of all, pressure 760 mm of Hg. Last class we did for barometer, same one again I am explaining here. For 760 mm of Hg, how that pressure would be with the help of hydrostatic law, rho gh. Now values we are putting here. Rho means density of particular liquid. We are taking mercury, Hg mercury. So 13,596 is mercury density. 9.806 is gravitational constant. H 760 mm. If you convert in meters, 760 by 1000 meters. So total value is 101325 Pascal. If you convert in kilopascal by 1000, 101325 by 1000, you will be getting 101.325 kilopascal. So 760 mm value I have converted in kilopascal. 760 mm of Hg, mercury value, using hydrostatic law. Now, first objective, he mentioned that 80 centimeters of Hg. For 760 mm Hg, we got pressure as 101325 Pascal or 101.325 kilopascal for 760 mm Hg, 760 mm. But here, in this objective, he is asking 80 centimeters. 80 means 800 mm. So for 760, we have 101.325. For 800, how can we get value? See, all of you, 800 by 760 into 101.325. Finally, we get 106.65 kilopascal. So for 80 centimeters or for 800 mm of Hg, the value of pressure is 106.65 kilopascal. Next one is 30 centimeters Hg vacuum. In objective one, we have 80 centimeters, which is more than atmospheric pressure. So that pressure which is available more than atmospheric pressure, we generally call as gauge pressure. But here, what they mentioned is 30 centimeters Hg vacuum. So if you want to find out absolute or actual pressure, I already told you in last class, for a vacuum case, absolute or actual pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure minus vacuum pressure. Atmospheric pressure in the problem, they mentioned that 760 mm Hg or 76 centimeters of Hg. Here vacuum value is 30 centimeters. So absolute pressure is 76 minus 30, which gives 46 centimeters Hg or 460 mm of Hg. Absolute pressure or actual pressure. For 460 mm of Hg, how to convert in kilopascal? Same procedure what we followed in objective 1. 460 by 760 into 101.325, which gives 61.328 kilopascal. So for actual pressure, how much we have got? For 46 centimeters of Hg or for 460 mm of Hg, the pressure value is 61.325 kilopascal. Next one is pressure due to 1.35 meters water gauge. Head value is given 1.35 meters. If you are having head and if you know liquid, easily we can determine pressure with the help of hydrostatic law, that is rho gh. Rho means density of fluid. Here he is talking about water, H2O. So water density is 1000. G gravitational constant 9.806, and head is given that head or height of liquid 1.35 meters. So I substituted, I got value 13238 Pascal. By 1000, you get kilopascal, 13.238 kilopascal. Like that, we calculate pressure if I have head and liquid density. Last one is 4.2 bar, simple one, 4.2 bar. 1 bar is 10 power 5 Pascal. So 4.2 into 10 power 5 Pascal, if you divide by 1000, you will be getting 4.2 into 10 square kilopascal or 420 kilopascal, simple one. So like this, we see units of pressure with different objectives. They have mentioned note here, when atmospheric pressure is 760 mm Hg or 101325, and for problems it is important, 1 mm of Hg is equal to 133.4 Newton per meter square. Remember, 1 mm of Hg value using this data, you can calculate individually. 760 mm of HG gives 101325 Newton per meter square. 1 mm of HG means 101325 by 760, which gives 133.4 Newton per meter square. Remember, nobody will give you in the examination, directly you have to take. Now we'll see one more problem. A vacuum recorded in the condenser. A vacuum recorded in the condenser of a steam power plant. Condenser is a heat exchanger which always removes heat from liquid which is passing through it and it gives to the surroundings. Amount of heat is rejected from system to surrounding. That is the objective of the condenser. Due to this heat rejection, the phase change process takes place. Phase changes, gas to liquid, phase will be changing. Finally, the fluid which is available after condenser is called as condensate. This thing you will be getting in thermal engineering too. So condensate, after condenser, the liquid or fluid which is available is called as condensate. Now, vacuum recorded in the condenser of steam power plant is 740 mm of HG. This is not absolute, he is talking about vacuum. The total vacuum in the condenser is 740 mm of HG. Too much amount of pressure has been removed. Find the absolute pressure in the condenser. Absolute pressure in the condenser in Pascal, he is asking in Pascal. The barometer reading is 760 mm of HG. Very simple to calculate with the help of diagram what we discussed in last class. I'll tell you now. See, all of you, this is a condenser. Let us assume condenser. I have attached a pressure gauge over it. Pressure gauge. This is a vacuum pressure gauge. Vacuum gauge. So outside pressure is atmospheric pressure, which is given that value as 760 mm of HG. Outside pressure is, our atmospheric pressure is 760 mm of HG. Inside the condenser, condenser always operates at very low pressure, which is always less than atmospheric pressure. That's why we call it as vacuum pressure. Very, very low pressure. Condenser always operates at low pressure, which is less than atmospheric pressure, by removing some amount of air particles. So you will learn about this one in thermal engineering too, in one separate chapter. I'm not discussing about this one now. So see, all of you, you are going to remove that air particles in the condenser. After removing of air, finally you got some amount of actual pressure. How much amount of vacuum we have inside the condenser? He mentioned that 740 mm of HG is vacuum recorded in the condenser. 740 mm. That's why, see all of you, I have attached a vacuum gauge. Over the vacuum gauge, you will be getting reading as 740 mm of HG. Vacuum gauge reading is 7.740 mm of HG. So generally student thinks that 740 mm of HG is generally they take as absolute pressure. Don't think that this is not absolute pressure, this is vacuum value. Vacuum means amount of air particles have been removed from the condenser. Now we'll see what is actual pressure which is having inside the condenser. We'll see now. Vacuum recorded is 740. By using vacuum gauge, you will get this value. Atmospheric pressure is 760. Now for vacuum case, we discussed in last class, the absolute pressure is atmospheric pressure minus vacuum pressure. Atmospheric pressure minus vacuum. Atmospheric pressure is 760 mm of HG. Vacuum value is 740 mm of HG. So total value is just 20 mm of HG. Very, very low pressure. Very low pressure. Too much amount of vacuum we have inside. So this 20 mm of HG, you have to be converted in Pascal. I already told you just now, 1 mm of HG is equal to 133.4 Newton per meter square. Newton per meter square gives Pascal. So 1 mm of HG is equal to 133.4 Pascal. So 20 mm of Hg means 20 into 133.4, which gives 2668 Pascal. Like that, we determine absolute pressure value with the help of vacuum. Now, we'll see one more problem, which is based on gauge pressure. Gauge pressure is nothing but amount of pressure which is more than atmospheric pressure. The pressure which is available more than atmospheric pressure or over the atmospheric pressure is called as gauge pressure. See, all of you, a vessel of a cylindrical shape, he's taking a vessel which is in cylindrical shape, is 50 centimeter in diameter. They mentioned that vessel diameter is 50 centimeters or 500 mm. And 75 centimeter height, 50 centimeters diameter, 75 centimeters height. So a cylindrical shape. It contains 4 kgs of gas. Inside the cylinder, we have 4 kgs of gas. Mass is 4 kgs. The pressure measured with the manometer indicates 620 mm of Hg. The pressure inside the cylinder, if you keep one manometer is nothing but a device which measures pressure. Otherwise, directly you can use one pressure gauge over it, no problem. With the help of one pressure measuring device, we got pressure value as 620 mm of Hg inside. Inside that container, we have 620 mm of Hg. Above the atmosphere, we clearly mentioned that 620 mm of Hg above atmosphere means over the atmosphere, still we have 620 mm of Hg pressure. More than atmospheric pressure, we have 620 mm of Hg. This pressure is called as gauge pressure. More than atmospheric pressure, what we have, that pressure is gauge pressure. So inside the cylindrical shaped vessel, we have gauge pressure as 620 mm of Hg. When barometer reads 760 mm of Hg, barometer always gives atmospheric pressure, which is 760 mm of Hg. Determine two things you need to calculate. First one is absolute pressure of the gas in the vessel in unit of bar, absolute pressure, and second one, specific volume and density of the gas. First of all, we write data, what we have, diameter of the vessel 50 mm or 0.5 meters, height of the vessel L is equal to 0.75 meters, mass of gas 4 kgs, manometer reading means gauge pressure reading 620 mm of Hg, barometer reading 760 mm of Hg, atmospheric pressure is 760. Now we have diameter and height, we can determine volume of the vessel. Volume of the vessel is pi by 4 d square L. We know, we substitute values, finally we got volume of the vessel as 0.147 meter cube. With the help of pi by 4 d square L. Now we'll enter into objective. First objective is absolute pressure. When we have pressure more than atmospheric pressure, that pressure is called as gauge pressure. The relation between gauge and absolute pressure is that absolute pressure is equal to gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure. In last class we discussed this, gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure. Gauge pressure is 620 mm of Hg, atmospheric pressure is 760 mm of Hg. If you combine these two values, you will get 1380 mm of Hg, 1380 mm of Hg. 1 mm of Hg means 133.4 Pascal. So finally, we got value 1.841 into 10 power 5 Newton per meter square, 1.841 bar. 10 power 5 Newton per meter square gives 1 bar. So finally, that value is 1.841 bar. This is amount of pressure, actual pressure what we have inside the cylindrical shaped vessel. Next one is asking that specific volume and density. Mass is mentioned in the problem, 4 kgs. Volume we determined with the help of diameter and length. So specific volume means volume by mass, 0.4147 by 4, 0.03675 meter cube per kg. Density means 1 by specific volume, 1 by 0.03675 which gives 27.21 kg per meter cube. Like this, we solve problems on pressure. Here, three types of things we discussed in these problems. One, if you know head, with the help of rho gh, we can calculate pressure. If you have vacuum pressure, how can we determine absolute? We know that one. Next one, if you have gauge pressure, how can we determine that absolute pressure? We discussed that. Like that, three different things were discussed in three problems. Next one is measurement of pressure. Next topic is measurement of pressure. How can we measure pressure? There are two different arrangements for measuring pressure. One is manometers and second one is mechanical gauges. We'll see now. What is manometer? Manometers are pressure measuring devices at a point. These manometers are used to measure pressure at a point in a liquid. A point in a liquid by balancing the level of liquid in a glass tube or container, whatever it may be, by balancing the level of liquid with the same or other column of liquid. It is the same or different column or same column of liquid. So like that, we determine pressure. There are different types of manometers are available. We'll see now what are they. Simple manometers, differential manometers. Simple manometer types were given. See all of you, piezometer, U-tube manometer, single column manometer. We'll discuss each and every one in future classes. Differential manometers, U-tube differential manometer, inverted U-tube differential manometer, macro manometer. These are differential manometers. Next one, a next device for measuring pressure is mechanical gauges. In manometers, we use a glass tube or pipe arrangement. By balancing that pipe or glass tube, liquid level changes. Based on that, the head value changes, pressure head value. With the help of pressure head, we measure a pressure. That is a procedure what we follow for manometers. But if you go for mechanical gauges, here an elastic element will be used. That elastic element is used against the liquid pressure to be measured. So based on that element, you can measure the pressure. There are so many types are available. See what I mentioned here. In these pressure measuring devices, an elastic element like spring is used against liquid pressure to be measured. Some of commonly used mechanical gauges are Bowden pressure gauge, diaphragm pressure gauge, bellow pressure gauge, dead weight pressure gauge. These are different pressure gauges. Will be discussed later. Now we'll see piezometer. We'll close this class. Piezometer. What is piezometer? Piezometer is a simple manometer for measuring pressure. Simple manometer for measuring pressure, but these pressure values always in moderate way. Only for low pressure cases we use piezometer. Piezometer is a single manometer, single element, a single column manometer, which consists a glass tube. Glass tube means there are two ends. One end is connected to one point where pressure is to be measured, and the other end is open to atmosphere. One end is you have to connect the point where the pressure is required to be measured. And the other end is always open to atmosphere, on which atmospheric pressure will be acting on fluid, which is in glass tube. See, this is arrangement of piezometer. There are two types of arrangements were given. See all of you, in first one, a vertical glass tube is directly connected to the point where pressure is required to be measured. In second diagram, a L-shaped piezometer tube has been arranged. L-shaped arrangement, glass tube or piezometer tube. See all of you, here, if you observe carefully, in piezometer tube or glass tube, liquid is reached up to certain limit. That limit is called as free surface. So free surface, above free surface, it is open to atmosphere. So if you want to measure pressure in piezometers, you always will be getting only gauge pressure value. Only gauge pressures. So gauge pressure you will be getting here with the help of head. Head. Let assume that head is H. So how can we measure pressure? Using hydrostatic law, rho gh. Rho means density of particular liquid what we keep inside the tube. G, gravitational constant. H, head, the amount of fluid rise in piezometer tube or glass tube. So with the help of that equation, we can measure pressure. Same thing I explained in points. See all of you, second point here. The surface of the liquid in the tube is open to atmosphere, and therefore piezometer measures always gauge pressure only. Gauge pressure means it is always more than the atmospheric pressure, above the atmospheric pressure. So if you want to consider absolute pressure, the pressure value what we get from piezometer plus atmospheric pressure you have to be added, then only you will be getting absolute value. It then in the last point, consider rho is density of liquid, h is amount of level in gas glass tube. Then the pressure at particular point can be measured by rho gh. We know that hydrostatic law. With that, we can measure pressure. What are the limitations of piezometer? Piezometer, just now in the beginning of piezometer, I discussed that it is only for measuring moderate pressures, not suitable for high pressure. Simple. Because here we are using only one glass tube which is attached to required pressure point. Only one glass tube which consists of simple glass tube. Single column has been attached. So if I maintain a single glass tube, if I use high pressure liquid in the container or in pipe, what happens? Definitely, the glass tube level has to be increased. For example, use water. Water, I am taking high pressure. Because of that high pressure means which is more than atmospheric pressure. For atmospheric pressure, if I use water, you have to maintain that glass tube height as more than 10 meters. If I go for high pressures, that height further has to be increased. Too much amount of height you have to be maintained. So which is not preferable for research and development case or laboratory case. So high pressure cases, you cannot get clear value for piezometers. Not suitable for high pressures because of difficulty in experimental setup. Next one is, it does not handle gases because here we have only free surface availability. Then only you can get sufficient amount of head level, liquid rise level. If you select gases, the free surface is not visible. You cannot get height. Without height, you cannot get the pressure value, means gauge pressure value. Rho g h is not possible to determine pressure because I don't know h. Without H, I cannot go with the rho gh formula. So, if free surface is available, then only you can go for piezometers. For gases, free surface is not available, so we don't prefer piezometers for gases. So, these two are limitations for piezometer. Next class, we'll discuss a problem on piezometer. Then, we'll go for another manometer. Thank you. That's all for today.